So my name is Aman Datta, and I've studied in Sheffield for 5 years now, and I studied mechanical engineering, MEng, and within that I also took a placement. So I worked with Rolls Royce CDS for a year as a product support engineer, and now I'm going back to them for my graduate job, which starts in September. That will be in Birmingham, Solihull. So in terms of strategy which I used to apply for jobs, I tried to apply to only the big companies, because I knew it for a fact that the small companies, they have a little bit of difficulty in sponsoring international students. So that was the first thing which I was really concerned about. So I only so the first thing I did was I looked up all the graduate employment sites. I put up an Excel sheet and I tried to list out all the graduate vacancies which they had advertised at that point of time. And I had columns next to each other in which I sort of marked out whether they were sponsoring international students, the location, the salary, what sort of a job role they were advertising. And based on that, based on my preferences, I filtered it and I applied to only a select few of them. And also I tried to keep in mind at this point of time the shortage occupation list, which usually the government puts out, just to have a fair idea of which areas are they sort of recruiting from. So the biggest challenge which I faced during my job search is I was finding it a little bit difficult to balance the time which I had to spend on my academics and the coursework and the time which I could spend on my applications. Because the thing is, I had deadlines all throughout from October to December, and that's the peak time when you have to send in all your applications. And most of the big companies, they have the deadlines around that point of time. In fact, I would say November is way too late to apply to the big companies, because even though they have the deadlines towards end of December, they usually close off around mid-November because they've received too many applications by that time. So to overcome this, I tried to obviously manage my time really well. I had to do that. So I tried to apply to just a select few companies which I was really interested to apply for, and the rest I kept it for after December. And meanwhile, I also tried to make sure that if I've set my goal during a week that I'll be sending in 5 to 6 applications, I tried to stick to that and I tried to send in all of them. Tier 2 visas are obviously difficult for most of the students to get, but the reason why I think I stood out is because I tried to keep my CV very brief and to the point. Because if you think about it, most of the HR, they spend very less amount of time to read through your CV. So it is important to get their attention so that you can move on to the next stages. And for the next stage, which is the psychometric test, I tried to make sure that I'm practicing a lot. I literally practiced hours before I took each of my tests, and that consequently helped me to finally get to the interview stages. And for the interview stages, I would say it's rather easier to get through, because then you're speaking to the assessor on a one-to-one basis, and they exactly get to see who you are as a person. So that was relatively easier. So I've used the courier service a lot. In fact, I went to the courier service repeatedly to get my CV and application answers reviewed on a one-to-one basis. And I also tried to go for all the careers fair at the university and also the company presentations which took around the university campus, because I knew like they were excellent opportunities for networking purposes. And I made it a point to go and speak to most of the HR representatives from the companies. And I also asked for some advice on my application and what is it that they're looking for. Most of them were very helpful, and they read through my CV and gave me instant feedback, which was very useful. And obviously I tailored my applications based on what they were looking for, and that eventually helped me a lot. So yes, courier service helps a lot. So in terms of my previous work experiences, I'd spent a year working with Rolls Royce CDS as part of my year placement, and that was very useful for my graduate job hunt. And I'd worked there during my placement, I'd worked as a product support engineer. In terms of advice that I would give to international students is, firstly, find out whether the companies that you're applying to, if they can sponsor international students or not, because you don't want to be in a position where you apply to these companies and then get asked to find your own sponsor. And that obviously isn't a very good position to be in. Besides that, I would recommend applying early, because if you want to beat half the competition, you have to get in your applications as soon as possible. I'd also recommend getting some work experience in the UK, because any work experience really helps to get a graduate job straight after you finish the placement, whether be it summer placement or an industrial, both works. And lastly, I would recommend making use of the career service. They are very useful. Make sure you're going to all the company presentations and the careers fair, because they are excellent opportunities for networking with the company representatives. And some of them, they even take your CVs off your hand from there itself. And they give you on-spot interviews as well. So make use of all the opportunities that you get around the university. and make the best of it.